And welcome to today. Yeah. Say hello, cat. Anyway, yes. What we're seeing here today is the Top Gear challenges 1, 2, and best of the challenges. So, let's talk about them. So, best of the challenges was the first, basically, the challenges we got from the Top Gear magazine. The challenges was the first DVD from the other four I showed you, these four. These here. That was the next one to come out. So yes. And then I believe it was the Polish special and the US special. But anyway, I'll be doing them next, right after this. Well, not after this, after I finish these little ones. So yes, Top Gear, best of the challenges, Top Gear, the challenges, and Top Gear, the challenges too. So, let's take a look at the first one. We shouldn't be long with these ones, unlike series 9, 10, 11. So, Top Gear, the challenges. Rotten old supercars, breaking down, rocket powered, mini flying, off ski jumps, ice water, shooting, mayhem. I don't know why they got full stops there, because that don't make sense. There's nothing like a good challenge. And that's absolutely true, coming from Top Gear. So here we got loads of clips, look. As you most probably notice, there's not much on here, as this is only 33 minutes long. Yes, but it's nice to have in your collection if you want to watch something quickly and to do with Top Gear. So, can a rocket propelled mini take on an Olympic ski jump and survive? Can a designed supercar be bought for just 100, well, 10k I mean, and driven around a track without exploding? Can a Volvo beat an Audi in a snow of, in a bound Bathalon? And can a Triumph Hell be turned into a monstrous crossbred with a dinghy and then sailed across a lake and more to the point, why? These are the challenges facing Jeremy, Richard and James. Will they fail? Will they fall at the first hurdle? The following experts are taken from the Top Gear Winter Olympics DVD. That's on sale now, and has been for quite a while now. And from the all new Top Gear DVD, The Challenges, due to release June 2007. So you probably know where this is going. And this came out in 2006, according to this. So it's 33 minutes long. Brilliant. And if you want to watch something quick and before work or something, these are the DVDs to do that with. So yes. Inside there's nothing much going on. We got pictures from Richard. Richard Hammond in his Ferrari there. Ferrari Dino. Hammond. James and Jeremy. We basically got the supercars, the amphibious challenges, and the mini. So if you want a quick, brilliant, just quick, brilliant Top Gear DVD, here's the one you need. You'll enjoy watching this DVD a lot more than I did making it. Not sure who that's trying to be say. I believe that's the producer of the show, Jeremy, Richard, I don't know, somebody. I don't believe it says anything about who made this. Anyway, now, for the one that came out in June 2007, Boys Will Be Boys. Almost 3 hours of ingenious plans, foolhardy ventures, and fuel-injected rivalry. Got Jeremy there, looking up. Richard and James, hands held together, focusing on the rocket that failed. So they're basically, this contains the challenges from series 7, 8 and 9. So you've got a Robin Reliant space shuttle, building amphibious cars, building a limo, a limo, Bolivia convertible, Parkour versus Peugeot, the Bugatti race from Alba, crap 70s supercars, and a few more that it doesn't show. I think maybe one or two it doesn't show on here. Seven fantastic challenges that test the mettle of the Top Gear team. The Top Gear boys, Jezza, Hamster, and Captain Slow can do brick horse powers, torques, and 0-60s until the bumps run dry. But when they take on a challenge, the action gets competitive, hilarious, dangerous, and at all times downright humiliating. Not sure about these feature lengths, 164 minutes, I'm not sure. I believe it was 1 hour or 2 hours, 50 minutes. So that's Chess Challenges 2. Challenges 1, I mean. Challenges 2 is here. Now they did two versions of this. They did a special edition, and they just did the normal version. The special edition came with a sleeve, which I did have, and it's gone. No idea where. But basically, yeah. Top Gear, the Challenges 2, Clarkson, Hamster, and Captain Slow, ambitious but rubbish. Plus exclusive DVD extras, more Lewis Hamilton and Simon Cowell, Take a Ride with the Stig, front row seat in the Eurofighter, with multiple angle options. Ambitious but rubbish. The Stig. Yeah. What I like about these is you get extras that you don't see from Top Gear, in the complete series anyway. You get extended stuff, you get behind the scenes Top Gear that you don't see on the show at all. And these run from Challenger 2 to the Challenger 6. And I believe there's some in one of the Top Gear magazines as DVDs as well. I think the Supercar one. I'll have to look that up again, but never mind. So, here we have the Amphibious Cars, the sequel. The Bugatti Veyron versus Eurofighter, Race Across London, Motorhome Racing, The Greatest Driving Mode, Fiat 500 versus BMX, 24 Hour Race, and I think there's about two more in there. I'm not sure. They don't cover all of them, as I said. Races, chases, and things on fire. A bucket load of Top Gear's attempts to get melted, hurt, or drowned. Two more cries of how hard can it be? That's not gone well. And your insufferable oaf. Jeremy Clarkson, Richard Hammond, and James May gallantly risk humiliation, excuse me, I can't even say that word, in another series of magnificent challenges where petty rivals are taken much too far. 139 minutes long. And I see, you can see that I bought this from the CEX shop, otherwise known as the sex shop, not the naughty sex shop, the place where you get your DVDs from. Cheap, and I basically bought quite a few from there. I bought Top Gear Revved Up, Back in the Fast Lane, and Winter Olympics from there. I bought the first Winter Polar Special and the American Special from there. I bought the Challenges 1, 2 from there. I bought Richard Hammond's Interactive Challenge, which one of them, and a few more. But they're the best place to go to find DVDs like this. I recommend them highly. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this as much as I have. I thought to myself, I'm going to start making Top Gear DVDs, as well as Doctor Who, which I'm currently at the stage of not doing any much because there's nothing to do anymore. It's just getting so boring at the moment. There's nothing new to look at. We get the same old stuff coming out every day and it's just rubbish. So, Doctor Who, you might get another one of them a couple of months' time, I'm not sure. But anyway, thank you very much for watching. And I'll see you next time in another series 12. 13 and 14 review in the next video, hopefully. So thank you very much for watching and good night.